Still a sports. She's a four-time world and three-time Commonwealth champion, and she's headed to Rio Olympics for a potential third successive Olympic gold medal. No pressure.
Valerie Adams worked her way back this year from knee surgery and earlier operations on her elbow and shoulder. So can she come out on top again?
She's back. Throwing 18 metres 85 at the Auckland Track Challenge earlier this year.
Valerie Adams, the reigning Olympic champion from New Zealand, reached 20.05.
But she didn't stop there. Valerie Adams cracked the 20-metre mark in Budapest and threw 20.05 metres in Monaco, tracking well for Rio.
Training's been going really well. I actually feel pretty good. I'm very blessed to be here. I'm very blessed to be able to continue what I do after my surgeries, after everything that's happened in 2015.
Surgeries on her knee, elbow and shoulder last year put her on the sideline for a bit, but now she's on the up.
No pain. I mean, you guys probably looking at all my strapping. I had quite a few straps on, but as an aged athlete, that's what happens. And I had more strapping on than most out there, but hey, you know, it kind of shows my age a little bit.
The focus is on next week, when she goes up against America's Michelle Kata and Germany's Christina Schwanitz, her chief rivals.
I have to think of my situation that I'm in right now and actually work off that. You know, I can't work off 5 years ago, I can't work off, because five years ago is five surgeries ago. You know what I mean? So we have to put everything into perspective.
But in the meantime, back to work she goes at her training base in Switzerland. This is the kind of grunt she needs to beat the fierce competition. It's not hard for younger athletes to be inspired by Valerie's achievements. For discus thrower Dina Hakeai, competing with the best is a privilege.
It's an amazing feeling, you know, as a kid watching them throw and now you're throwing against them. It's just an overwhelmed feeling.
Although the 22-year-old just missed out on the 61-metre throw needed to qualify for Rio, she's not fazed.
Training now, it's good, just working on technique. So all our hard training, we did that in winter. So all the heavy weights, heavy training. And right now it's just more working on speed and technique.
And for Adams, exposure for younger athletes is key.
They're young, you know, they're just having fun, and I think for them this is a good experience to be, you know, in front of the crowd competing at an event. The future of track and field in New Zealand has been great for when I started. I think that's going to continue on to 2016, also 2020 after that, so hopefully we can see some big things from these athletes.
And all the best to all of our athletes for Rio.
Absolutely. How exciting. Good luck. Well, that's the end of our show, unfortunately. If you want to catch any stories again, you can go onto our Facebook page or TVNZ On Demand.
And just a reminder, we've got our SunPix Pacific People's Awards nominations are now open.
That's right.
We've got so much to celebrate. We've got fabulous talent everywhere you look.
Why we do this work.
Oh man, this is massive.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much again.
This is for you.
We're now celebrating leadership, emerging leadership. We're celebrating business. We're celebrating health and well-being.
Thank you. Lots of love.
Have an amazing evening, everyone.
These awards bring together the community to recognise the wide range of Pacific success.
Exciting times. I hope you vote for me. Nominate me.
You're so amazing.
Oh, I think we just told the nation. Anyway, no ora mai ki a manui a tō koutou e pe tōma ka kite.
Arera. Tangata Pasifika, born a people proud, people of the south, to our new homebound. Tangata Pasifika.